Alright gang, back on the road today, and I don't know about you, but very, very bittersweet, because that was such an unforgettable 2 weeks of just relaxing in paradise. Ash and Grady were such fantastic hosts to us and the kids that we just felt like we were at home from the minute we arrived. And God, we have really exhausted everything that they had to offer. There was not much left unturned, and what an amazing 2 weeks it was. So very, very grateful and thankful to them, and very sad to be leaving them. Yeah. But we're now heading to Guelph, just out of Toronto, where, and this also has been very long anticipated, we've got Scotty and Ash at the other end waiting for us. Now, Scotty's gone to an extent beyond no one else. I mean, he bought a house and then thought this would be great. It's going to be fantastic. Then he heard that Mick and Court were just going to come and elope. So he goes, well, it's actually now it's not good enough. So I'm going to just drop bank on it and fully renovate it. So really looking forward to catching up with these guys and just seeing what class of a handyman he calls himself. I'll see you soon. Sorry, mate. Sorry.
Oh,
fucked up. Sorry about that.
Really? That was so dangerous.
Well, I was looking
too much about what's going on.
I was looking in the rearview mirror at the fucking pole that I nearly hit on the side of the trailer. That's what I was looking at. I was following the car in front.
Oh, is that a big parking lot?
Did you park on that?
I'm not really sure.
So you're going to get to the bottom of Gordon Street Hill. There's going to be, you'll see a little ice cream place, the boathouse.
Yeah.
Come past it.
Yeah.
Oh, you passed me. Shoot, you passed me. Make a right on water.
Perfect thing.
Man, this is money. Fuck. Hey, bud.
Give him a high five.
Wow, you got massive. You got big and strong over the summer break.
Hi. Oh, did you see Emmett? Oh,
little Emmett.
You
got big. Okay, so let's be honest. What does Courtney really want to see first?
I don't need to do laundry this time.
Where is the laundry and is it running?
Every time I go somewhere, because I'm always there's chockers in the laundry. I'm like, all right.
Where's the laundry?
So the laundromat's actually downtown. You just got to turn around the laundromat.
Oh, shit, this is awkward.
Yeah. There should be some room for the laundromat. You got coins, right?
Look at the rubber gloves on there as well.
Where's the
tent? This is called the good lot.
So, quick update. After I've changed my relationship with alcohol, I've arrived and 6.2% has changed our perspective of where we're going to park this thing. Originally, Scotty said, no, we can't fit it in here. It's going to be too tight. Scotty, you haven't had a go. You haven't had a crack. So now we're going to try and maneuver the 50-foot truck and trailer into this tiny little driveway. You watch this happen.
Okay, your back is now at the pole. You're back now at the pole.
Do I need to be more aggressive with my turn, like snap it in, or just go straight back on that line, over?
Snap it in. For a better day. Great line. Keep coming. Come straight back.
So, quick update, we've got a bit on here. We've arrived at Scotty and Ash's and changed all the plans we've been planning on for ages, and we've just parked right front and center, just pretty much at the front door. And it's been a really quick turnaround because we're heading straight into the heart of Toronto now for an Illumi light festival. 5.5 years ago, Courtney and I were in Dallas, Texas, and Lola was 6 months old, and we took her to Enchanted,
I can't
which is, I think now, by getting here, looking at this, very, very similar. So I'm going to dig up a couple of those photos and compare them to this. But
she was in our little carry pouch at that point. Now,
can you imagine
how much... She's nearly as tall as me.
Carry pouch right now would be very good. This big guy. Pretty sure kids are going to have nightmares tonight. Yeah, this is awesome. Nom nom nom, nom 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 nom.
That's pretty annoying,
I'm
not
going to lie. Banana back.
You know what, this is Mum's worst nightmare.
Oh, yeah.
Yours
and my mom. Worst nightmare? Can't say I'm a fan of spiders. Holy! Wow.
Listen to the music.
Yeah.
This is incredible.
Yeah. I can't even pack a Christmas tree up. Imagine the job putting this away.
Look at that!
San Diego. Creeping around. Mum would love this one because there's a Lucky Panda poker machine that she always plays.
And your dad loves Chinese food at that Golden Sun. Oh, we've lost our children. Featuring Luther Douglas MacArthur.
Yes!
What? Oh,
yeah.
Well, it's a cargo. I don't know what that is. Oh, I do know this song.
Dad!
Oh, yeah, that old chestnut.
Dad!
What's going on here, Luke? Lucky Dad hasn't had a gummy.
Okay. Ice hockey.
your face. You big
disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place.
Alright, get off. I don't like seeing you on a cock. I won't go on about that one. Snakes, mum.
Bro, that's my worst nightmare.
Well, it's an absolutely cracker of a day here. It's a Tuesday. 31 degrees is the temperature today. And it's a big day for a lot of the locals because it's the first day back at school. Yes, the summer break has officially finished, but summer itself, I feel, has only just started. This is the second consecutive day where we've been over 30 degrees. And we are in Guelph, a lovely little university town, so there's a lot happening. And this, ladies and gentlemen, it's a covered bridge that's been built and held together with no nails whatsoever, mortise and tenon joints and pegs and stuff, so that was pretty impressive. Talk about a tourist trap. We've just arrived. It's $5 all day to park, which costs $10 somehow. But anyway, no need to go on about that. This little town is just full of everything tourists, which I'm really instantly regretting having two kids by myself. It's going to cost a freaking fortune spent on junk and rubbish and games and stuff. But anyway, that's what it's all about. Let's have some fun. You're obsessed with haunted houses, bro. Why don't we go and have a look at what we came for? Look at the waterfalls down there. Yeah, so on the other side of there, that's America. Yeah. Remember me when you try to breathe under the water. You see my face, but I can't be the one that pulls you from your heart. Remember I'm in your corner when it's you against the water. You hot, buddy?
It's really hot. He's whinging. I'm over it.
Hi, Will.
Can we get the dinosaur? You
different Niagara to what we experienced 15 years ago.
Yeah.
And for those of you who intend to come here with children,
don't.
An hour is too much. 59 minutes of that hour was spent pulling them away from the lure of dopamine overloads and garbage. Sensory, just carny filled garbage. I would much prefer that Niagara Falls would have been like preserved as a national park or something, but it's just
tacky.
Yeah,
the falls are still really spectacular though.
Unbelievably spectacular. Like breathtaking, amazing, and now they've just really played the tourist card way too hard. That was hard work, to be fair. But we got a nice photo.
Yeah, couple
of, yeah, and it's a beautiful day.
Yeah.
Like Christ Almighty, everything else doesn't need to be there. Anyway, Niagara on the lake for some peace and some quiet, and hopefully a nice lunch.
Lunch, yeah.
Baby, you can do what you like with whoever you wanna. So why remember me when you try to breathe under the water? You see my face, but I can't be the one that pulls you from your
water. Well, this is a classic example of if you build it, they will come. We are at Downey's Discovery Farm here in Ontario. It's about an hour drive from pretty much any form of civilization. But I tell you what, we are told that this place absolutely packs out on the weekends. We've got it on a Friday afternoon, school's back, pretty much got it to ourselves. Timing is amazing. But you can just see how this would really fill up, and got hours and hours of fun for everyone. It is such an awesome concept. Love it. You were raised on an asphalt farm. Ain't never heard a rooster crow. Never walked. You never rode in the hay, you never thrown it in four wheel. Climb up on in here, girl, let me show you how country feels. Put your hair down, hair down, get you some of this laid on back. Kick your shoes off, kick them off, get you some of this slow down fast. I'll take you up and down these hollers and hills, let me show you. Ever watch the sun go down?
Yeah, well, I'm pleased with his butcher.
You ever been so into somebody? You're still lying there when it comes back up. Girl, what do you say? We cut a path through that cornfield, parked down by the water. Let me show you how country feels. Let your hair down, hair down. Get you some of this laid on back. Kick your shoes off, kick them off. Get you some of this slow down fast. I'll take you up and down these hollers and heels. Let me show you how country feels. Some of this laid on back, kick your shoes off. Put your hair down, hair down. Get you some of this laid on back, kick your shoes off, kick them off. Get you some of this slow down fast. I'll take you up and down these hollers and heels. Let me show you.
So a couple of things to note here. We're at a market and I just came across a stand that sells meat pies and sausage rolls. Very excited. So obviously I bought a steak and mushroom and a sausage roll, and when she rang it up it was $18. And they're frozen. You gotta heat them up at home. So whilst I thought that was interesting, I also find this very interesting. This little coffee shop looks lovely. Very proud that it came sixth. Like, very proud that it came sixth. Good for them. It's quite an accolade. Yeah, like, that's a blue ribbon. Thanks for coming. See you never.